I will create a new views.py file with a route called rate/limited. Later, I will create a limiting decorator to restrict the number of requests. I should point out that for this example, I'm using the IP address as the identifier of the client. This way, rate limiting works even for non-logged in users. But you can change this for your implementation of future projects. Redis is an open source in-memory data structure that can be used as a database, cache, and message broker. Redis provides us with a fast way to keep track of endpoint requests that is also scalable. Your Vagrant machine already has Redis installed. Just run Redis server from inside your Vagrant machine to fire up this Redis instance. You can now point to your Redis instance with the code here. Now I will make a class called RateLimit that takes in the new object model introduced in Python 2.2. I will make a variable called expirationWindow that will give my key an extra 10 seconds to expire in Redis, so that badly synchronized clocks between workers and the Redis server do not cause any problems. I will now create an init method for the RateLimit class, taking in itself the variables keyPrefix, limit, per, and sendX headers. Key is going to represent a string that I will use to keep track of the rate limits from each of the requests. Limit and per define the number of requests we want to allow over a certain time period. And sendX headers is a Boolean option that will allow us to inject into each response header the number of remaining requests a client can make before they hit the limit. I will define reset here to make a timestamp to indicate when a request limit can reset itself. Then I will append this to my key. We use a pipeline to make sure that we never increment a key without also setting the key expiration in case an exception happens between those lines. For instance, if a process is killed. I will now increment the value of my pipeline and set it to expire based on my reset value and expiration window. I'll add two lambda functions to calculate how many remaining requests I have left, and another one that returns true if I've hit my rate limit. I will define the getViewRateLimit function, which will retrieve the viewRateLimit from the G object in Flask. I will use this function later on inside of my decorator. I'll also make a function called onOverLimit that returns the message that a client has reached their limit of requests, along with a 429 error, which means too many requests. Now, I will create a rateLimit method that will wrap around my decorator, taking in the following values as arguments. The key is constructed by default from the remote address and the current endpoint. Before the function is executed, it increments the rate limit with the help of the rateLimit class and stores an instance on the G object as g.viewRateLimit. If the view function is indeed over the limit, we automatically call a different function instead. Now, I will append the number of remaining requests, the limit for that endpoint, and the time until the limit resets itself inside the header of each response that hits the rate-limited request. This feature can be turned off if sendX headers is set to false whenever the rate limit decorator is called. And speaking of rate limit decorator, I can now add the rate limit to my route. Here it's currently set to allow 300 requests per 30 seconds. So if everything worked well, I can fire up my Flask web app and run this hungryclient.py file I made in order to see how well my rate limiter works. I will tell hungryclient to send off 2,000 requests per minute, or as fast as it can. As you can see, HungryClient is successfully reaching the endpoint until it hits the limit. Then it waits 5 seconds and tries again. Once the time limit is reached and reset, more requests can be made until we reach 2,000. Code for this activity is available in the instructor notes.